Good morning to all of you. Today we are going to discuss about the imperfections in solids. Imperfection in solids means here imperfections in crystalline solids, because in this chapter, the solid state, we have discussed about the different aspects of crystalline solids, and this one is also related to the crystalline solid. And we know that in case of crystalline solids, the constituent particles are arranged in a regular or definite pattern. However, the solid may suffer from some defects. Usually, a solid consists of an aggregate of large number of small crystals. These small crystals have defects in them. This happens when crystallization process occurs at fast or moderate rate. The defects are basically irregularities in the arrangement of constituent particles. Now, the types of defects, two types, point defects and line defects. Point defects are the irregularities or deviations from ideal arrangement around a point or an atom in a crystalline substance, whereas in case of line defects, there is the irregularities or deviation from ideal arrangement in entire rows of lattice points. So here you can see the difference between these two, that is the point defect and line defect. In case of point defect, it is related to the irregularities or deviation from ideal arrangement around a point or an atom. Whereas in case of line defects, the irregularity or deviation from ideal arrangement in entire rows of the lattice points. So here it is the difference between these two. Now we have to focus our study on the point defects because it is in our syllabus. So here we will discuss about the point defects. First, about the types of point defects. Point defects can be classified into three types. First, it is the stoichiometric defect. Second, impurity defects. And third one is non-stoichiometric defects. We have to read or we have to know about these three. First one, the stoichiometric defects. These do not disturb the stoichiometry of the solid and are also called intrinsic or thermodynamic defects. Means due to this defect, the stoichiometry of the solid, it will not be affected. Means the stoichiometry, it will remain unchanged. There are two types of this stoichiometric defect. First one is vacancy defect, and second, it is the interstitial defect. Now, about the vacancy defect. This type of defect occurs when some of the lattice sites are vacant in the crystal. This results in decrease in density of the substance. This type of defect may also develop when a substance is heated. Now, consider this figure. Suppose it represents the small portion of the crystal, and these circles, suppose it represents the constituent particles. Here, suppose the particles are arranged in a regular or definite pattern. But here you can see, in this case, it is missing, the particle is missing. Here, one particle or constituent particle or atom whatsoever is here, it is also missing. So the vacancy, here one vacancy, another in the other place may also occur. Due to this, the vacancy defect, it will occur, means due to the occurrence or development of vacancy in the site, means particles are not present there, vacant space is there, in place, means sites are vacant, therefore it is termed as the vacancy defect. Next one, interstitial defect. This type of defect occurs when some of the interstitial sites are occupied by the constituent particles. Suppose it represents the sample, small portion of the crystal. These are the particles. And suppose some particles, they have occupied the interstitial site. These are the interstitial site. Suppose one particle is here, another it is in the interstitial site. So this type of defect, it is termed as the interstitial defect, and this increases the density of the substance. The above two types of defects, that is the vacancy defect and interstitial defect, are shown by non-ionic solids. Ionic solids show these types, or show these two types of defects, as Frankel defects and Schottky defects. Ionic solids, they will show Frankel defect and Schottky defect. First one about the Frankel defect. In this type of defect, the smaller ion, usually the cations are smaller, is dislocated from its normal site to the interstitial site. Consider this figure. Suppose cation anion in this way, the particles are arranged. Now consider this space here. One cation, it is means not present in this site, but it is present in the interstitial site. So here the dislocation of that cation to the interstitial site is here. Therefore, this type of defect, it is also called dislocation defect. Due to this type of defect, the electrical neutrality, it will remain unaffected. The density, it will also remain unaffected. And due to this vacancy, the conductance of the solid, it will increase. This type of defect does not change the density of the solid. Frankel defect is shown by ionic substance in which there is large difference in ions. Large difference means large difference in the size of cation and anion. For example, suppose zinc sulfide, silver chloride, silver bromide, etc. Consider this case. Suppose first one, it zinc sulfide, ZnS. Zn is present as Zn2 plus, and sulfur it is present as S2 minus. This Zn2 plus, this cation, it is very small compared to this S2 minus sulfide ion. Similarly, in AgCl, smaller cation, very small cation compared to the chloride. Similarly, in this case also. So here, this type of defect, it will occur in such type of ionic substance where there is a large difference in the cation and anionic size. Next one, it is the Schottky defect. This type of defect arises due to the missing of equal number of cations and anions. Equal number of cations and anions. Consider this figure. Cation, anion in this way. Suppose the ideal it may be there. But here, suppose cation, then it should be here the anion, but it is missing. In this case also, anion, then here it should be the cation, but missing. Here is also, suppose here cation is missing. In this case, anion is missing. So here, equal number of cations and anions are missing. This type of defect also decreases the density of the solid. The density of the solid, it will decrease. But the electrical neutrality of that solid, it will remain unaffected. Means it will remain electrically neutral. But the conductance, it will increase due to these vacancy, means vacant place or vacant sites in the solid. Schottky defect is shown by ionic substance in which there is comparable size of cation and anion. Comparable size means there is very less, means atom ionic size difference cations and anions almost similar, comparable size. For example, NaCl, Na plus Cl minus, not so very large difference in their ions in size. KCl, CSCl, AgBr. Now you can see here, this AgBr, it is also in the example of Frenkel defect, and also here in case of, it is the example of Schottky defect. Here, this AgBr, it can show both Frenkel defect as well as Schottky defect. The question it is asked, what is that ionic compound which can show both type of defect? The answer it will be AgBr or silver bromide. It will show Frenkel defect and Schottky defect. Next one, it is the impurity defects. Whatsoever we have discussed earlier, there is no impurity inside that solid. But when foreign ions are present as impurities, then it is termed as the impurity defect. Foreign atoms ions may occupy the lattice site or interstitial sites in the lattice. Defects in the ionic solids may be introduced by adding impurity ions. If the impurity ions are in a different valence state from that of the host ions, vacancies are created. For example, in case of crystallization of molten NaCl in presence of small amount of strontium chloride, during the crystallization, some of the Na plus ions are replaced by strontium divalent ion. Each Sr2 plus ion replaces two Na plus ions. It occupies the site of one Na plus ion and the other site remains vacant. In this case, the cationic vacancies thus produced are equal to the number of Sr2 plus ion. Another example, it is here, solid solution of CdCl2 cadmium chloride and AgCl silver chloride. Now consider this diagram. Suppose it represents the crystal structure of NaCl. Na plus Cl minus, Na plus Cl minus, Na plus. Suppose no defect, then in a definite pattern it should be there. But when there is the presence of Sr2 plus ion, means during that crystallization, in the presence of small amount of strontium chloride, some of the strontium divalent cation, they replace the Na plus ion, and that strontium divalent ion, it takes the site of one of the Na plus, and since one Sr2 plus ion, it replace two Na plus ion. That's why one site, vacant site, it will be occupied by that Sr2 plus ion, and the another it will remain vacant. So here suppose, initially here, suppose when there is no defect, then here it will be the Na plus, here is also Na plus. But one Sr2 plus ion, it has replaced two Na plus, one from here and another from here. This place, this site, this one site, it is occupied by that Sr2 plus ion, and another it will remain vacant. Similarly, in case of suppose CdCl2 and AgCl, solid solution in case of this one, suppose in case of AgCl, this Cd2 plus ion it will be present. Suppose Ag plus Cl minus, Ag plus Cl minus, Ag plus, in this way, regular, no defect. But when Cd2 plus ion, means one Cd cadmium divalent cation, it will replace two Ag plus ions, one of the site it will occupied by the Cd2 plus ion, another it will remain vacant. So this type of defect, it is termed as the impurity defect. Next one, the discussion it will be on non-stoichiometric defects. Okay, take care, thank you, and have a good day.